हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज शिरोभी एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज माय बुकट्यूब चैनल द कैफिनेटेड रीडर। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ वेरी हैप्पी इंटरनेशनल कॉफी डे टू ऑल द कॉफी लवर्स आउट देयर। हैप्पी स्पेशल डे, दैट्स द थिंग वी ऑल नो टू द फॉर द कॉफी लवर्स इन अस। दिस इज अ वेरी स्पेशल डे फॉर अस एंड सिंस इट्स लॉन्ग दैट आई वेंट आउट एंड हैड सम ग्रेट कॉफी, सो आई थॉट ऑफ ट्रीटिंग माई सेल्फ टूडे इन दिस स्पेशल डे विथ कॉफी एंड दैट वॉज ऑल द रीजन्स ऑफ सच अ डिफरेंट वाइब, बी इट इन होम और आउटसाइड एंड द डिफरेंट स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द वीडियो। आई रियली वॉन्टेड यू ऑल टू एन्जॉय द इंटरनेशनल कॉफी डे एज मच एज आई एन्जॉयड हैविंग द कॉफी आउटसाइड आफ्टर सच अ लॉन्ग टाइम एंड इट वॉज वेरी डिलिशियस। सो येस, दैट वॉज इट, आई जस्ट गेव यू अ ग्लिम्स। सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू टूडेज रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल कॉफी डे। Since it's a special day, so I want to suggest you a great book that deals with coffee, has coffee involved in it, and that is probably the best suggestion I can give you today, and it's the Before the Coffee Gets Cold by Toshikazu Kawaguchi. Now the Dirk fans out there, please say hi in the comment box below because you are gonna love this recommendation because it deals with time travel, science fiction. And the cherry to the cake is it also has magical realism sprinkled upon it. Isn't it great? Okay, so the thing is, in this story, the synopsis, if I give it without spoilers, will be like, there is a cafe that provides its customers with the unique facility of going back into the past and meet one person for the last time, but they cannot change the past or alter the consequences or the sequences or the events that happened in the past because the past has to be the same because the present is determined by it. Isn't that sound some kind of dark things? That's the reason I say dark fans are gonna love this because I, true to the power, and I really loved it and it was really great. So we are presented with four main characters. Each one of them have their own reasons of going into the past, and since going into the past involves violating the laws of the universe, so here also risks are involved and rules are applied. So one of the most important rule while going into the past is that you have to return into the cafe, into the present, before the coffee gets cold. And failure to that leads to some disastrous consequence which has no possible solution. And throughout the story, I kind of felt so ecstatic with joy, kind of sometimes felt like, shit, why she did this? She would have understood this if she would have done this. She means there were regrets, there were guilt. I personally felt the writer has waved the story in such a beautiful and mundane day affair that you are gonna relate yourself to many of the circumstances and many things we do and we regret at last. So here constantly the author presents before us the question, whom would you meet for the last time even when you know you cannot change it, even when you know that the consequence is going to happen, even when you know that it will be the last time, and how will you react in that moment when you know that you have to return to the present before the coffee gets cold? It's a very beautiful and heartwarming story. I personally loved all the four stories, that is the four protagonists having their own reasons of going into the past, and I really hope that you are gonna love it because it involves coffee with such a blending of time travel and magical realism and all that stuff. I really 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 loved it, and the only the drawback which I felt was, since this is my first Japanese stuff I read and this is my very personal problem, I felt there were too many names and too difficult to remember them. I got confused at first, like 20 to 30 pages, but after that it got okay. So that is my personal problem. If you are into animes or Japanese movies or Japanese books or anything as such, you are gonna love it, trust me. This is worthy of reading, this is all worthy of your time, this is all worthy of your investing of your emotions and thoughts and everything. Trust me on that. Do give it a read and thank me later for the recommendation. So guys, that was all about the recommendation part. I hope you love the book, because if you haven't read this book, you are missing out a great deal of happiness and introspection. Coming to the positive quote of today, the positive quote of today would be, a coffee is a hug in a mug by, I don't know who, I really don't know who gave this, but I really found this very realistic for the coffee lover, so I just gave it true to the sentence, coffee is really a hug in a mug, and that's it, because International Coffee Day demands everything about coffee. So if you have liked my video, do give it a like, comment what I should change, what you like the most, what you would recommend me to do, and everything that's necessary that you feel I should do. Share it with your friends, family, close ones, everybody, the coffee lovers, everybody you think would be interested to watch it and would love to watch it. Subscribe to my channel because I post every week and you might be wanting to see more. So yes guys, do like, share, comment, subscribe to every good thing that is necessary to make me and make my channel grow. Till the next time, bye bye.